pleasure to present these keys to our faithful and dedicated trustees, Brother Ray Herbert, Brother Robert Herbert, and Brother Isaiah Herbert, and Mr. McCormick. One thing about you, if you make a mistake, you're a stranger.
That's right.
Present these keys as an interest and security for this church.
Yes.
May God bless you in who trust these keys or left. Do you, as ministers and trustees, accept these keys?
Yes, sir. Yes, we understand and accept these keys.
All right. Praise God. Yes. A great deal. All right. I'm presenting these keys. It's three, four keys, so we just going to present them at this time. Amen. Now, as trustees, it is your duty and responsibility to be the pastor to the church. Praise of the Almighty God. Congregation,
we dedicate this house
for the worship of our righteous God, the Son, the Holy Ghost, and the celebration of the Holy Sacrament, congregation.
We dedicate this house
for the preservation of the church, the standard operation procedures throughout all generations, and for the furtherance of this ministry on earth, congregation.
We dedicate this house.
And all together,
we dedicate this house and consecrate ourselves. We, the people of this church and congregation, are grateful to God that we now dedicate ourselves to a new worship and to the service of Almighty God through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior.
While we stay on this short dedication prayer, most worship God, we come now. In the mighty name of Jesus, we give you the glory, give you the praise. For we have dedicated this house to you. As you charge, amen, David, to build a house, but you found within David's heart, amen, that he had done some things that you desired for David to do, so David could not build your house. But you provided a son called Solomon that came along, amen. You charged him with the same responsibility that Solomon charged people from all over the nation to bring the best of the best to build his house. And they did. Solomon did build your temple. And the people of God then had a place to come into assemble. I say in this community, amen, and all around this community, people do have a place to come and worship and to be relieved and to remove out of their state, amen, of not knowing where you are directing them. To remove out of their comfortable zone. They could come here, amen, and learn and find out about themselves and become better individuals, better husbands, better wives, better children, better Christians in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Short word for today, amen. Some old friends of mine.
Yeah.
They're not old. I said old meaning in long time knowing.
Fix it up now. Fix it up.
Pacific, right?
Fix it up now.
Let's put it this way. I want to introduce some acquaintances of mine that I've been known for a while.
All right. Fix it up.
I like for the lessons to stand crazy. We go way, way back.
Amen.
We used to belong to the same church.
Amen.
And the lessons were there, and they are originally from Pompano. They live in Riviera Beach now. And Pompano folk out of there.
Yeah.
And they said we wouldn't miss it.
Yes.
Amen. And so they are. We are here today.
Amen.
And to each and every one of you in your special place, for the people that promised me that they was going to be here, and I see your face, so I'd like to acknowledge you at this time. All of you, praise God for all of you that said you would be here, and you are here today.
Amen. Praise God.
Too many more names calling, but so I have to do that process. I will be there. He said, Pastor, it ain't but one thing that's going to keep me from being this service Sunday. He said, and then I'll be dead.
Woo, Jesus. Woo,
well, he was dead. Thank God he lived there. And I'm saying that it has to go. Distinguished gentleman, Bishop Glover.
Yeah. Boy,
Bishop Roy Glover.
Yeah.
And he'll give you a few minutes of what God has envision for him to build in the city of West Palm Beach.
Amen.
Amen. And I'm proud to be on the board of directors of the Jesus Christ Worldwide Christian Center that is going to be coming to West Palm Beach. My wife and I are board members on there. And Bishop Glover is doing some special things.
Yes, he is.
Amen. He is in the midst of billionaires, millionaires and billionaires.
Yes, he is.
And I met a few of those millionaires the other day.
Yeah.
I shook hands with a few millionaires. By the way, I'm a millionaire.
Amen.
Right. I am a millionaire. Amen. Praise God. Don't come begging me for no money. I put it like this, I was a millionaire. I know a billionaire. I know a trillionaire. I know him personally.
Yeah.
The name is Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. But I want
that's
him to give us a few minutes before I give this message, and he'll tell you some exciting things.
Amen. Yes. Amen. All right.
God bless you, church.
Amen. Amen.
You know, when you're driving down the highway and you look at your gas tank and you see it's going on E, I've been going ever since Friday. Mm-hmm. And I'm just a little tired.
That's all right.
I just want y'all to forgive me for not staying, because I think I've been on about 4 hours of sleep since Friday. But as the pastor, my good friend, has stated that I was walking with some millionaires, and we plan on building a 25,000 seat Christian center in West Palm Beach. The last time I was here for your focus on heaven in 2011 conference.
That's right.
I stated to you all that we had 35% of $390 million.
Yes.
So we serve a mighty God.
Yes.
Somebody say we serve a mighty God.
We serve a mighty God.
On Friday, as I labored with those millionaires.
Yes.
They told me it was a done deal. They have the donors to go to get the other $269.5 million.
Praise the Lord.
That sure excites some. Excited that we had a gospel concert last night, and I beat the bell off my tambourine. You know, when David danced before the people and his wife got jealous, you know, some people are jealous of
me. That's right.
But I beat that tambourine last night until my hands got sore. And I was right back up at 6 o'clock this morning, because we had one of our friends fly in from New York, Sister Beverly Cherry. And you all get a chance to hear her. She's awesome.
My God.
And then we had Missionary Society today at the church. So I've been busy, okay?
Yes.
Now, when I was here last time, I stated that, well, I gave out 8 membership, lifetime membership. These memberships are worth $5,000 if you will go on our website.
Yes, they are.
Which means that anytime there's an event at the center, I don't care what kind of event, whether it's a concert, whether it's a religious event, or a sporting event, you get in free. That person get in free, they got free valet parking. They sit in the luxury box suites, and they get complimentary hors d'oeuvres. So I just want to bless this ministry. I want to bless my friend, Pastor Herbert, and his lovely wife, Gwendolyn, and this congregation. Is there a Lisa Lane here?
That's all right.
And we have Sister Stephanie. y'all forgive me.
Amen.
Going back to West Palm Beach in the morning, get to bed. Is your lifetime membership card?
Jesus,
by the time you get to me, you got to
be. Hey, glory!